Lieutenant Governor Jacqueline Coleman is joining us live tonight with an update on the situation. We appreciate your time in this tragedy. I want to begin with the status of the ongoing search and rescue efforts. What are you hearing tonight about people who are looking for lost loved ones?
And thank you so much for having me. And first, let me say that for all of our first responders and local leaders across Kentucky that are on the ground, all of the communities that have come in to support the search and rescue teams from elsewhere, thank you so much. It's truly helping us to reunite families and to bring peace to people who need it. Today, when we were in Mayfield with President Biden, we received an update from the Mayfield police chief, where he said that they had completed 4 search and rescue missions in Mayfield. And so I can tell you that that's the most up-to-date information I have from that area. And it was one of the harder hit areas that I think a lot of folks tend to see a lot of coverage on, but we still have about 75 people who we know we have lost and 100 that are unaccounted for. And we will continue to look for those folks, and we don't give up hope in Kentucky. And so we're gonna keep working to reunite families and as long as we can.
Mm-hmm. How is the search going through the night? Are they able to continue to look 24 hours?
So what a lot of our emergency management leaders in at the local level and as well as at the state level have done is they have divvied up all of their folks, you know, the volunteers that show up. We have National Guardsmen and women, I think over 600 now, that have been deployed to assist. And they have divided those teams into shifts so that some folks are able to go home and get some rest, which is needed, especially in times like this. But the search doesn't stop. And so we still have folks who are working around the clock on search and recovery missions, on cleanup. It truly is a remarkable feat what these communities have put together in such a short amount of time, and the progress that they have made in such a short amount of time.
A monumental task. Lieutenant Governor, it looks as though Mother Nature will skirt just to your north tonight with this next massive storm system, which is fortunate news for so many in the search. Sadly, though, it does look like there's another system that's heading through the Midwest tomorrow. How are the teams in your community preparing for weather as you face this continued and ongoing search for survivors?
Yes, and my heart goes out to the folks who are in the line of that storm, and I certainly hope that they take heed for those warnings in other states as these storms develop, and take the safest protocols you can. It's better to be safe than sorry. I can certainly say that after seeing what our fellow Kentuckians have gone through. But what I will say is, When it comes to our local officials, our emergency management folks, they are already thinking through next steps in terms of shelter, in terms of safety for fellow Kentuckians, to make sure that everybody's taken care of. Actually, after I was in Mayfield with the president, Governor Beshear, I went on to Princeton while they went to Dawson Springs. And in Princeton, as I spoke with the mayor, he was telling me how they were planning their debris cleanup and pickup around impending weather. And so I know that our folks are very aware of that, and they are doing the best that they can as quickly as they can, but also being mindful of that additional weather that's coming in. But I just cannot say enough about the leadership that we're seeing in some of the toughest times that have hit this state, and the compassion that we're seeing across Kentucky. It really has been remarkable.
The helpers, it warms your heart. Do you have an idea or a sense on how many people in your state are seeking shelter tonight on night 5 after this twister?
So I don't have an exact number, but what I can tell you is one of the things that the governor did to make sure that we could put a roof over everyone's head is he ordered the state parks open to our state parks are now opening their doors, and they have been for several days, to make sure that folks are in who don't have shelter. And so we are actually making sure that anyone who needs shelter because they have lost their home or have been displaced, find it there. And I heard him say today in Mayfield, as we were talking, that we had about 100 rooms available at 2 state parks in the western part of the state, and we want to fill them up. So I know that that's a move that we continue to push. But listen, these families, our churches, they are taking in their neighbors, and they don't want them to have to leave the community. And so they really are rallying around each other.
A lot of big hearts in the great state of Kentucky tonight and all across the country. We're thinking about you as you continue this effort in finding those who are still lost and the beginning of a very difficult rebuilding process. Lieutenant Governor Jacqueline Coleman, thank you for coming on tonight.
Thank you.
Our best. There are a lot of ways that you can help those impacted by these storms. We have a link to the Red Cross donation page on our website, newsnationnow.com/help. Thanks for watching. Click the red subscribe button below so you can get more of NewsNation's fact-driven, unbiased coverage.